This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, as a follow-up to a previous video, I want to give a few more examples of horizontal asymptotes of rational functions. So let's take a quick look at the two kinds of situations that can create horizontal asymptotes. If the degree of the numerator is less than the degree of the denominator, the horizontal asymptote is going to be y equals 0. If the numerator and the denominator have the same degree, the horizontal asymptote will equal the ratio of the lead coefficients. Okay, so let's just look at a bunch of examples and see how these rules apply. Here I've got y equals x squared plus 2x minus 7, and that's over 5x to the third plus 2x squared plus x. So we're always going to be concerned with the degree of the polynomial in the numerator and the denominator. Usually that will be the first term that you see in the numerator and the first term in the denominator. I'll put a little box around those first terms. The degree in the numerator is 2, there's an x squared. The degree in the denominator is 3, that's 5x to the third. And so the degree in the numerator is less than the degree in the denominator. That's going to mean that we have a horizontal asymptote of y equals 0. To explain why, basically we can think of this function as equaling approximately x squared over 5x to the third. And when we reduce that down, we're going to get 1 over 5x. And as x gets very, very positive or very, very negative, in other words, a large value, what we're going to have is going to be 1 over a very large number, and that's going to be very close to 0. So the horizontal asymptote will be y equals 0. Let's look at this example. Y equals 8x to the third plus 2x minus 1 over x to the fourth plus 6. If I look at the first term in the numerator and the denominator, that's where I'm finding the degree of each one. I've got a third degree, 8x to the third, over a fourth degree. So the numerator has a lower degree than the denominator. I can say that this function is going to equal approximately 8x to the third over x to the fourth. That's what's going to happen when I get further and further away from 0, when x is a large positive or negative number. I can reduce that fraction to just 8 over x to the fourth. And as x gets very large, I'm sorry, 8 over x. And as x gets very large, even though I have an 8 in the numerator, the fraction will still become very, very small. Okay, so once again, the horizontal asymptote for this one will also be 0. Here's another one with a horizontal asymptote of 0. I've got y equals negative x squared plus 7x plus 3 over x to the fourth minus 5. Well, here the degree in the denominator is considerably greater than the degree in the numerator. The numerator has a degree of 2, denominator has a degree of 4. The fraction will equal approximately negative x squared over x to the fourth, which would reduce down to negative 1 over x squared. So once again, as x gets large, this fraction will become a very small number. Okay, so in each of these examples, we had a horizontal asymptote that was y equals 0. Let's look at some ones for the other situation, where we're dealing with the ratio of the coefficients. So here I've got y equals negative x to the fourth plus 7x to the third minus 2 over x to the fourth plus 3x squared plus 5x. Both of these are fourth degree polynomials. So I'm just going to look at the term with that x to the fourth in it. That'll be the first term in each one. I've got negative x to the fourth. So actually the lead coefficient for that is negative 1. In the denominator, I've got x to the fourth, so its lead coefficient is 1. And that's going to mean that I've got a horizontal asymptote at y equals negative 1. Okay? Another one where we're looking at the lead coefficients. This is y equals 3x squared plus 2x, and that's over 6x squared minus 8x plus 4. So that will equal approximately 3x squared over 6x squared. The degrees are the same. I can actually just cross out the x squared in both of these terms. And don't forget to reduce your fraction if you can. I've got a 3 over 6, so that means that my fraction will reduce to 1 half, and my horizontal asymptote will be at y equals 1 half. Okay, and just want to show you one example where this will not work. Here I've got y equals 4x to the third minus 2x squared plus x plus 1 over 3x squared plus 8. In this one, the degree of the numerator, 3, is greater than the degree in the denominator, which is 2. And so this will not yield a horizontal asymptote. It's going to give you something called a slant asymptote or an oblique asymptote. I've got a video for that if you want to take a look at it. But the main thing to remember in terms of the general rules for horizontal asymptotes is going to be that if you've got the same degree in the numerator and the denominator, like this one, then you're just looking at the ratio of the lead coefficients. If the degree in the numerator is less than the degree in the denominator, the horizontal asymptote will be y equals 0. Okay, I hope that helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.